Next month, a NASA representative will begin a 5.5-year journey to the second best place in our solar system to find life. Why the second? Well, the first is Earth, and we're already pretty sure there really is life here. This robotic representative goes by the name Europa Clipper, which reveals its target, Jupiter's moon, Europa. And while it won't be landing there, its equipment will help astronomers search for aliens swimming in an ocean that's larger than all of ours put together. Science fiction writers have been talking about Europa as a place to find extraterrestrial life for decades. Take Arthur C. Clarke's book 2010, his sequel to the legendary 2001 A Space Odyssey. Or the 2013 found footage movie Europa Report, where if the moon's deadly environmental conditions don't kill you, the giant tentacled sea creatures that live there surely will. But that's fiction, not reality. So what do we know about the real Europa? Well, it's the smallest of Jupiter's four main moons, and it's roughly the size of our moon. But because it's orbiting Jupiter, that puts Europa over 5 times further from the sun than we are. So its surface is way colder than you ever see in places infamous for their chilly temperatures here, like Antarctica or Siberia. I'm talking negative 140 degrees Celsius during the middle of the day. But beneath Europa's surface, things get warmer, thanks to tidal heating. Basically, big old Jupiter keeps tugging on Europa as it spins and swings around in its elliptical orbit. That causes all of Europa's rock and ice to stretch and squeeze, creating friction and therefore heat. But is it enough heat to melt any of that ice? Well, over the decades, humans have sent a bunch of missions to visit the Jovian system, like 2 Voyager probes in 1979, Galileo in the 1990s, and Juno, which is orbiting Jupiter right now. And from these missions, scientists have gathered pretty solid evidence that Europa has a very not-solid subsurface ocean. It's sitting beneath a massive shell of ice that's probably 15 to 25 kilometers thick. But the evidence also suggests that the ocean itself is even thicker, stretching another 60 to 150 kilometers into the moon's insides. And that means Europa could have twice as much water as all of Earth's oceans, even though it's way smaller than our planet. But to build and sustain any potential Europan sea critters, you don't just need a decent supply of liquid water. You also need chemical ingredients in that water, like nitrogen, phosphorus, magnesium, basically the kinds of things you get in a multivitamin. And lucky enough, Europa's ocean seems to have them. It also might have hydrothermal vents on the seafloor, which here on Earth are a place many scientists think some of the first life may have evolved. Sidebar, there is one other moon in our solar system that ticks a lot of the same boxes, Saturn's moon Enceladus. It's a good bit smaller than Europa, as is its subsurface ocean, but it has these cool geysers where the water plumes can shoot up through cracks in the ice shell all the way into space, making it easier to analyze. In fact, the Cassini spacecraft got to fly through one of those plumes to metaphorically taste that moon's water. Scientists still aren't positive whether or not Europa has plumes, but either way, its huge warm ocean full of the right elements makes it the hottest astrobiological target right now. And scientists have spent decades trying to get a space probe to Europa, where the moon is the primary target and not a side quest. A dedicated Europa mission has been floating around since the late 90s, but Europa Clipper only started construction a few years ago, back in 2019. At one point, the mission proposal even included a separate lander that would, well, land on the surface. But clearly, someone rewatched the movie adaptation of 2010 and remembered HAL 9000's warning that humanity should attempt no landing there, and the lander got scrubbed. Or, you know, maybe there were budget cuts. So when Europa Clipper arrives in 2030, it will have to fulfill its 3 goals from a distance: to measure how thick the ice shell is, to check that the ocean has the right chemicals for life, and to look for signs of geologic activity, like plumes. Basically, the science team wants a comprehensive view of Europa's ecosystem, so they can determine what, if any, kinds of life could be there. To make that happen, the spacecraft will stay in orbit of Jupiter, but loop around Europa about 50 times over the course of 3 years, using 9 different scientific instruments to probe what's happening both on and inside this little ice ball. To keep its equipment warm and toasty that far from the sun, it'll be wrapped in one of those shiny blankets you get after running a marathon. And to protect its computerized brains from Jupiter's intense radiation, it's got a proverbial safe made of an aluminum zinc alloy whose walls are about 1 centimeter thick. With solar panels that stretch as wide as a basketball court and a total mass equivalent to a large elephant, Europa Clipper is the biggest thing NASA has ever made to visit another world in our solar system. NASA's expecting to launch this big guy in October. After the launch window opens on the 10th, they'll have 21 days before Earth, Mars, and Jupiter move out of alignment for the flight plan that they've picked. But don't worry too much. If NASA misses this window, they can try again next year. If all goes according to plan, Europa Clipper will swing by Mars this coming February to get a little speed boost, and that will send it back towards Earth for a second final speed boost that'll get it to Jupiter by April 2030. Juno might not be there to greet it. That mission is only scheduled to run until 2025, but Europa Clipper won't be alone for long. The European Space Agency's JUICE probe is also on its way to Jupiter right now, but it's taking a longer flight path, so it won't get there until 2031. Together, they'll help us uncover the secrets hiding beneath Europa's icy shell, and if neither finds aliens, they can at least inspire the next generation of science fiction stories. Now, whether you plan on throwing a launch viewing party or not, we at SciShow have a way for you to celebrate. We have a limited number of Europa Clipper pins that are ready to ship right now, so you can have one in your hands or on whatever object you want to pin it to in time for the October launch. You can order yours now by heading over to complexly.store/scishow.